You shake my nerves and you rattle my brain. Too much love got me insane. You broke my wheel. What a thrill. Goodness gracious, great balls of fire. You know, Jerry Lee's still going strong, Mom.
Still going strong.
And he must have liked that scene, hearing the song on Top Gun there.
Mm-hmm. He's a big Top Gun fan.
So we sent the limos for you because you're going to want to hear this. Look at the first one in the good book. So what have you got to tell us about the reality of the female Homo sapiens menstrual cycle? Sounds like a hell of a country song, that
it's
one.
It's a rough business.
Mixing Hindu Kush with kosher Kush, and my new strain will be called Gripping Hearts. I'm going to knock you out. We sent the limo for you, so you got to get in the limo because we're taking a ride out the country road. And Jimmy Joe, the driver, is putting the radio on right now and taking us time traveling, right? Taking us back to what?
The 50s, Dad. But I'm so lonesome I could cry.
Oh, I thought we were doing that other one. Oh, okay. She's talking about Hank Sr. Okay,
Hank.
Can I put the hat on because this is a cowboy song?
Yeah, do it. Do
only
it.
Cowboys get this lonesome, Mom.
Yep.
Jerry Jeff's train songs and Hank Williams' pain songs. Did you hear that long song a whippoorwill? Sound too blue to fly. That midnight train is winding low. I'm so lonesome I could cry.
Do you ever see her open when leaves begin to die? Like me, he loves the will to me. I'm so lonesome I could cry.
For the silence of falling star lights up a purple sky. And as I wonder where you are, I'm so lonesome I could cry.
I've never seen a night so long when time goes crawling. The moon just went behind the clouds to hide his face and cry.
To hide his face and cry. Did you hear that long song? Whippoorwill sounds too blue to fly. And as I wonder where you are, I'm so lonesome I could cry. I'm so lonesome I could cry. I'm so lonesome I could cry. was on the radio? Jimmy Joe had it on the radio? Or are we already in the limo? Did
we're,
I already do
we're
that?
We're getting in now, right now.
Oh, I didn't tell him to get in the limo?
I don't think so.
Yeah. Well, get in the limo. We sent the limo for you because we got to take a ride out the country road to Cornfield of Dreams where the old, it's like Kevin Costner's only, he's not baseball players, he's old singers and artists come out of there and they request their songs. So we got to get out there and then we go out to the station, the studios, Brawler Room. Finish the show out there and the whole thing only takes a couple of minutes. And we'll fill you in on the way about the menstrual cycle. Is that when I sing Losing You Might Be the Best Thing Yet?
No.
Okay. What do you got now, Mo?
Oh, the ride.
Ride. Gonna take a ride.
Gonna take a ride.
Gonna take a ride.
Gonna take a ride.
Up as a honky tonk.
Up as a honky tonk.
Up as a county line.
Past the county line.
Through the amber waves of green.
Through those waves of green.
And past the dairy cow.
With the big brown eye.
Through the old cornfield of dream.
Cornfield of dream.
Only Molly can see these guys.
Oh,
who's
Dad?
Who's coming out tonight, Mom?
We must have called them out, Dad. It's Hank Williams, Senior Dad. He wants good looking and jambalaya.
Oh, all right. Sing Hank Williams all night long. Hey, goodbye, Joe. Me gotta go. Me, oh my. Oh, hey, me gotta go. Say that bill. Read down the bio. Oh, my, he bone. He's the sweetest one. Me, oh my. Oh, when the sun is gone. Go, happy fun. Down the bayou.
Son of a gun, we're gonna have big fun down on the bayou.
With the tippy toe and the fountain low, there's the place is buzzing. All the kinfolk come to see Vaughn by the dozen.
By the dozen.
Who is dressed in style? We know why, oh, me, oh, my. Oh, oh.
Son of a gun, we're gonna have big fun.
Down on the bayou.
Son of a gun, we're gonna have big fun down on the bayou.
Hey, hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? Hey, hey, sweet baby. Don't you think maybe we could find a brand new recipe? I got a hot rod board and a $2 bill.
I know it's pop
right over the hill. So to pop and dance in three. Won't it fun come along with me singing, hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How about cooking something up with me?
How about cooking something up with me?
Oh, I'm free and I'm ready. We can go steady. How's about saving all your time for me? I said no more looking. Knows I've been tooking. How's about keeping steady company? I won't throw my day book over the fence. Buy me one for 5 or 10 cents. Keep it till it's covered with age. Writing your name down every page. Singing, hey, good looking. What you got cooking? How's about cooking something up with me? How's about cooking something up with me? How's about cooking something up with me? Bigger than oh, we gotta get the girlies' toes?
Yeah, get out on that old country road
we
back.
We gotta get
limo
out of here because everybody's getting their toes are getting too hot.
It's hot in here.
And all the girlies' toes.
All the girlies' toes.
Hanging out of the window.
Hanging out of the window.
Somebody sees a great big tower, 50,000 watts radio
station. GHRT.
The station GHRT.
Station GHRT.
Is there for you and me?
Is there for you and me?
Brought to you by Ellis's Restaurant and General Store.
Anything you want
down at Ellis's Restaurant. Down at Ellis's Restaurant. Gonna go in the station up the front desk and see Betty Page. Cigarette girl uniform, give you your special tea, the Hiawaska, and send you down the stairs here. Psychedelic Prairie Home Companion. The really big old time radio medicine show, Three Chords and the Truth, starring Molly Griffin, Old Dog Duke.
And the Reverend Dr. Joe G2 coming to you live from Station GHRT in the virtual haystack in your mind, where the show always starts in 5 minutes. We don't spin the tunes on the turntable, we spin them on our souls. So kick back, chill out, and relax to the mellow sounds of the singing DJs.
I'm spinning my heart. Ba-boo, boo, ba-boo, ba-doo, 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 bum, ba-ba-doo, ba-doo, boom. Oh, Mr. Sandman, bring me a dream. So what have you got to tell us, Mom? Because I got a message from you.
Yeah, did you read
coming
it?
Over it on of, the internet.
It's kind of long and
no, it was too long. I couldn't read it. And so what I did was, is I said, get the good book, you guys. Put down to say, so what have you got to tell us about the just a minute.
The human female
menstrual cycle. The reality of the female Homo sapien menstrual cycle and whole reproductive and procreative female show.
So, here we go.
It's the female show.
Here we go. Human females, pretty much like the only ones who menstruate like we do. No one does it quite
heavy.
Like us.
Yeah. Heavily.
Heavily.
But the bigger bigger mammals, right?
Primates
just
do
right
it
in the beginning. I read
yeah,
a
the big primates.
Yeah,
do it
the
too.
big primates.
But other animals, and she starts off with explaining our pregnancy, because other mammals can keep living their lives through pregnancy. They can keep hunting, they can run, they can do everything they need to do.
And you're pretty buggered.
Yeah, humans are kind of useless. Yeah.
Well, they
or
are
useless.
All around, even the offspring is like really, really vulnerable.
Yeah.
We're very vulnerable.
Yeah, so it has to do with our embryos get the placenta sac, digs through our uterine wall and starts sucking the blood out of our bodies. Other animals' embryos just kind of like gently take some stuff from their blood vessels, or it's not as near as like invasive as it is with us. Like with
they're
us,
aggressive.
They're aggressive. And they've got the DNA from the dad helps them be aggressive. It like triggers them to be aggressive. They take control.
Yeah, right. Get in there and get the blood.
The embryo has complete control over the hormones. You're out. The woman no longer has control of her hormones. It's the embryo that's controlling them and everything. So it's a takeover. It's an aggressive takeover. So our menstrual cycle evolved to be aggressive too. In order to any embryos that were not going to be worth going through that shit, get flushed out every month.
Yeah. Your uterus is like, you are a host fish.
Yeah.
And your uterus is parasitic.
No, the embryo.
Oh, the embryo.
Yeah.
Oh, it's not the uterus that's going after the blood?
No, it's the embryo and
oh,
it's
I
placenta.
Thought you said the uterus.
No, it's the embryo. It's the baby. It's so aggressive, and so we've evolved.
How does it get that blood?
like it
well,
grows
never mind.
Anyway.
Yeah.
So our period is so intense so that we flush out as many embryos as we can. Like you got to be a good embryo to get through that.
Now we're talking evolution.
Yeah.
Oh yeah, baby. It's natural selection.
Yeah.
That's what they call it.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
It's rough, but it's true.
It's a battlefield in there.
Yeah. Yeah, and I thought that was kind of high, 15% of women. I wonder how much doctors had to do with that, 15% of women get in big trouble.
Yeah.
Well, I got some questions about that.
There's a lot of questions that need a lot of answers. Anyway, let's sing Losing You, Dad.
Yeah.
Just like the...
That's a good one to sing
just
right
like
after
we flush
that.
Out that embryo. This is what our uteruses sing.
This is before political correctness.
It's in a C-sharp. C-sharp, Dad. C-sharp, Dad.
Oh, now the girls They're always like cutting up their trucks, and on that one they killed him. I was sort of glad they did.
Earl.
Yeah. But you know, it's usually women beating on things.
Yeah.
Back in the day, you could men could do it a little bit too. They could a bitch a little bit, at least bitch.
They bitch.
Now where do I, am I here now?
C sharp. But they can't be aggressive anymore.
Just hold on. Now it's hot in here. It's getting hotter all the time. Now listen. Oh God, that listen.
I think it's wonky.
It ain't perfect, but I'm pretty good at that, Mom. Are we gonna do it that slow?
Uh-huh.
There's no such thing as sleep with jealous fools. And being jealous about someone like you, sort of foolish too. Oh, I wanted you and you wanted anyone you could get. Oh, losing you might be the best thing here.
Losing you might be the best thing here.
The longest day I live, I still be suffering from the shame and in the gutter you were making yourself quite a name. All the life you chose is the one you won't again. Oh, losing you might be the best thing here. Oh, losing you. You didn't want to hang in there.
No. I was panicking a little bit.
Yeah, you were panicking. I seen you panicking there. I said I'm mixing the. I don't even know if I got these strings right, but I need real powerful ones. Mm. Mixing the Hindu Kush with the kosher Kush. Oh, that one's strong. That kosher Kush is strong. Mm. Oh yeah, straight from Israel, that baby.
Yeah.
Nuclear. Kosher Kush. And my new strain will be called Gripping Hearts. I'm going to knock you out. Do you like it?
I think it's really good.
You know, the reason I made it up is because I get such a kick out of the names.
Yeah.
Oh, there's a lot of creativity in the names of the Marahuchi strains.
All right.
Where are we now?
Marahuchi Coochie.
Where are we now?
We're going to sing.
Are we at the show yet?
Yeah, we're going to sing Circle Game.
Oh, my God. God.
Yesterday,
what a bunch of melancholic songs, but this is kind of good.
I figured I didn't have the energy to keep up with the high energy things, Dad.
What key do you want this in, Ma?
B, Dad.
That's where we are.
No.
Nope, it's not where we are. We got to go back to here. All right.
Yesterday.
I know. Yesterday a child came out to wander. He caught a dragonfly inside a jar. Oh, he was tearful when the sky was full of thunder.
Fearful
and tearful at the falling of a star. And the seasons, they go round and round. And the painted ponies go up and down. We're captive on a carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we and go round and round and round in that circle game. You could have just stopped playing in that part. 16 years and 16 summers gone now. Cartwheels turn the car wheel through the town, and they tell him, take your time, it won't be long now. You're gonna drag your feet to slow the circles down. And the seasons, they go round and round. And the painted ponies go up and down. A captive on a carousel of time. We can't return, we can only look behind from where we came, and go round and round and round in a circle game.
In the circle game.
It's in the circle game. I just thought we'd brief ourselves on the chord before we do the, you know. It was two more.
Yeah, I know.
That much time again.
I know.
To do that. That's the one problem I got with that song. That's why I want to do
But it's good. I
about
like
the
all
rain.
The verses.
I like the, what's that?
I love a rainy night.
I love a rainy night. Because that's about all the words in it.
Yeah.
Ah, that's the kind of songs I like.
I love a rainy night. I love a rainy
night. Now, I was thinking, Ma, about the definition of racism. It's gone insane. Because according to how everybody's talking,
yeah,
I'm not just a racist. I'm a sexist. I'm a countryist. That would be nationalist.
Yeah.
Although I'm not sure what country. That's the only problem I got on that one. Now, I'm a neighborhoodist. I'm a teamist. Mm-hmm. I'm a occupationist. A familyist. Mm-hmm. Etc. If ist means you have a
judgment,
general knowledge of a group, mm-hmm. and their character, mm-hmm. and you have an affinity for the group as well, too, right? Mm-hmm. Natural affinity, even in your occupation. Mm-hmm. Other truck drivers, other,
yeah.
you know what I mean?
Yeah.
That shit is just so in our DNA.
Yeah, you're not getting rid of that.
You know, but I looked this up, but this is not the way they're using the word racist.
No.
But I looked up the word racist, and it means you want to hurt somebody.
Yeah.
As soon as you see him.
Yeah.
Because of his race.
Yeah.
How many people are like that? Not many, right?
Oh.
It's like sick people,
yeah,
right?
Yeah, they're mentally ill.
Yeah. So I just want to straighten that out. Mm. Well, now we got it straightened out. Everything's going to be all right.
I'll tell the world.
Yeah. And if you want to see a good show, it's that one, Clint Eastwood. What's it called?
Gran Torino.
Gran Torino. Because we've been being bullshitted too. Mm-hmm. That's all there is to it.
Oh, they're just trying to tear us all apart, aren't
yeah,
they?
Yeah, I know. And apparently they're telling this war is going on now. It's a proxy war. Do you know what that means?
No.
Well, I think it means
nearby.
It's not really what you're seeing them talk about it.
Mm.
It's about the whole influence of the West and the States and
right.
you know. And that's what Putin and those guys know, you know. So I don't know what the hell I'm gonna do about it. I know. I got to have it worked out by the weekend.
You're going to be that guy.
We're in big trouble. Big trouble. Yeah. Okay, what do you got, song?
Glory Days.
Oh. Well, maybe this would be best to say this before Glory Days.
Do it.
Okay. Well, you know how I've been suggesting that I may be the second coming?
Yeah.
Well, over the weekend, I turned my grape juice into wine. That's a sign, isn't it? That's a joke.
I got it, Dad. I smiled. I smiled hard.
Here's a song from The Boss for you. We make it very melancholy. Is it in a B?
Yeah.
Yeah, I make it a lot more melancholy, don't I, Mom?
You do, Dad.
Because I'm acoustic. But I'm wearing a Bruce Springsteen t-shirt.
You are.
Now I gotta remember what
I had a friend who was a big baseball player.
I had a friend, he was a big baseball player. Well, back in high school, he could throw that speedball by you, make you look like a fool. Saw him the other night at the roadside bar. He's walking in, I was walking out. We went back inside, we had a few drinks, and all he kept talking about was glory day. Pass you by, glory day. Wink of a young girl, like glory day. Glory day.
Pass you by, glory day. The wink of a young girl's eye, glory day. Glory day.
There's a girl and she lives up the block. And back in school, she could turn all the boys' heads. Sometimes I stop by on a Friday. We have a few drinks before she puts the kids to bed. Her and her husband, Bobby, they split up. Oh, I guess it's 3 years gone by now. We just sit around talking about the old times. She says when she feels like crying, she starts laughing, thinking about glory day. Pass you by, glory day. We give a young girl's eye, glory day. Glory day. I think I'll go on down the well tonight. Gonna drink until I get my fill. I hope when I get real old I don't
sit around talking about it.
Yeah, but I probably will.
Yeah, you will.
Just try to recapture a little of the Gloria. You know the time slips away and leaves you with nothing messed up but the coolest stories of the glory day. Pass you by, glory day. Wink of a young girl's eye, glory day. Glory day. Pass you by, glory day. Wink of a young girl's eye, glory day. Glory day. New ending there, Ma. Producing right on the spot. Okay, well, your lives will never be the same. Did we have health things? We weren't. The impetus of your motivation, very beginning thing in your brain, is to evolve. And survival and procreation are an integral part of that. But if you cooperate with your reptilian, subconscious, whatever brain, life gets better. Right now, creative growth and development, that's your brain evolving. Now, listen to me. Y'all coming down here for the health. You know why you do that? Because when you got your health, you got just about everything. Now, you pea pickers, y'all come back now. And down in London, France, and underpants pea pickers, Chad, China, and Belarus. Good crack down in Ireland. Y'all come back now, you hear?